have fun and yeah, that's it.
That's you performing, man.
I feel like, you know, I mean, singers like in rumba, yeah, well, a lot of them, you know, like you know, from Puerto Rico, you know, like they know, you know, they. But now, you know, like on bands like that.
That's not what a real B boy does, Mustafa.
You're about to be commercial soon.
I don't know. See, maybe one of these days we see you on Broadway.
You know what? With the show that we're doing, Ghetto Made, the Rock City show, maybe that can happen.
Yeah, that's what it is. That's crazy. So when you were just playing for the love of it, right, before this translated into dollars and cents, did you do street playing? Did you just say, you know what, I'm just going to sit over here and play?
Yeah, I will. I mean, that's what I love. Yeah, that's what I love to do. I love to, I mean, That's how I got started, like playing in the street with my people, my boys or whatever. You know, like we just go to the corner. You know,
like subway.
You don't have anything to do. Yo, let's go play. We go play right next to the beach. So that's love.
Put a box down to make a couple of dollars.
I can do that too. But I mean, but I'm saying, back then. Yeah, I used to get like money, but not like now. I mean, I get more money now when I play with DJs because, you know, I play in hotels and they book me. But I mean, you know, if it's like people like.
Before you were just Jancy, now you're Jancy Gonzalez. You can't play on the beach in the street anymore. You need a gig, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're doing it big.
But I just want to like go over there and, you know, be down and have fun with the guys and everything. Yeah, I just have to do that, you know, like, I don't do it, like, all the time, but, you know, when, every time that I get a chance, you know, like, they call me, I call them, I mean, what you doing or whatever, well, let's go, you know, I just want to throw down, I just want to rock, and they'd be like, yo, come down.
So, these are your girls, do they have names? Because, you know, musicians are weird, musicians are funny people, do they have names, the girls over there?
Are you talking about congas?
Yeah.
No.
You call congas?
Congas, yeah.
That's it?
But they're babies, yeah, but I mean,
I know,
yeah.
You know, because y'all musicians are very particular and temperamental about your stuff.
What she's saying is kind of like, you know, B.B. King,
yeah, Lucille. Right, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's
what I'm saying.
You got anime with Little Richard, his piano.
Right,
you know?
That's what I'm saying. The congas are her
name? I can call them, those are my nanas, my girls.
Nice.
My nanas.
Yeah, there's a nanas, but we're going to find some names for them.
I treat them good. I just hit them hard.
Yeah, they like that. You beat them. We get it.
Like, yeah.
Show us a little technique. You know?
Yeah, right? Come on, let's do a little something over here. Hold your mic. This is going to be nuts, people. Brother King Muhammad, I wish you was up here. Oh, man. We needed you up here. Yeah, this would have been it. All the time, y'all ain't gonna get that nowhere here but here. Nowhere. He didn't even work up
a
sweat.
We wanna take a little video break.
Yeah, let us. Let us. He was into it.
That's just something right there.
That's a man that's passionate for his nanas. Passion beat on the nanas. We're gonna go to a video.
Bye, guys. See you later.
punch with the hands. We're back. That video, I was just saying, listen, Jancy, the glass is coming off. It's like the gloves coming off. Yeah, it's like
he's on now.
Yeah, it's on and popping. Watch this.
Go to war now.
Yeah. Now, here's the thing. He is self-taught because he comes from a musical background.
Yes.
He plays all his percussions by ears.
Mm-hmm.
So he plays the congas, he plays cymbals. What else? The cowbells? The cowbells?
Cowbells.
I love those.
All the percussion, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you play any caracas also?
Yeah, like, maracas. Yeah.
Maracas, right.
Yeah, that's like live percussion. I play maracas, güiro, campana, palitos, all that. Yeah. And conga, timbales, and bongos.
The percussionist. Yeah, that's like his name.
This is a movie, like the piano.
Right.
The percussionist.
Yeah, that's going to be it.
Under 17, not permitted without parents.
Exactly.
That's a good one.
Exactly. I'm going to get a little, I'm not playing anything because I'm not going to embarrass myself or hurt his girls. But we were talking about the skins have.
Yes.
We're going to see how much he learned. That's what this really is. Different notes.
Yes.
All right, first of all, how do you know which is, does the label go to the front or the back? Is that the front or the back?
No, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter where it goes.
So then how do you know?
It's supposed to be, when you tune them, they're supposed to be even, all of them.
Okay.
So it doesn't matter if he's like this way or that way or whatever. So, I mean, you just got to learn how to tune the instrument.
All right, so that's sounds, with these.
This is like, you know, tie them up.
Right.
But all of them at the same time.
Okay.
So they can be even.
All right, so then how do you know what note is for where if there's no front and back?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, but that's the hand. That's how you got to use the hand.
Oh, the hand makes the note, makes the tone.
Yeah, if you hit them like soft or if you hit them like with this, mm-hmm. this part right here, you see, it sounds like a little bit deeper.
Right.
And then if you hit it like a little bit harder, but right in the middle of the conga,
right,
it sounds like higher.
Ah.
It's like low.
You see?
And then has another one that is this one right here. That's the bass.
Right. Okay.
That one is the bass.
So it's all like in the hand technique,
It's
really.
In the hands. Yeah, you got to use your hands like in different ways so it can sound different. You make the sound.
Okay, so you know what? That's a lesson to me because I thought the skins, the way they were tightened off a different note around, but it's really all in the hands.
All around, it's all the hands. Yeah, you got to know how to use your hands.
You gotta know how to use your hands. Sometimes you need the open hand.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you need the flat hand.
Yes.
Sometimes you need the cupped hand. I'm just saying. That's how it goes. Now, does size matter? Because one is taller than the other. Does that make a difference? Does width matter? This is so PG, right?
If you like, right now, they just lend them to me, and one is from our friend, this one from Willie.
Right.
So I gotta use them. But normally, they should be even, you know. So like that, when you just move or whatever, you know, like. You know, it's easier for you. But right now, I just like freestyling, so I do what I got to do. I don't care.
No, but I mean, does size matter as far as sound? I mean, like with one being taller, one being wider.
Yes, it does.
It does.
But not a lot, but it does. Yeah. It's not a big difference. It does. What it matters is like how you tune them in, you know, like
it's all
in
tuning.
So one is going to be like higher, and this is going to be lower. See?
Gotcha.
Yeah, that's what it matters like.
The record size doesn't matter, but
yeah.
That's for the record. But I like that. Okay, so that was for real. That was a lesson because I really thought that there
A lot of people they think the same thing, but it's not. That's not how it works.
Hence why I could never play even if I tried because I thought one thing I would I'm not flat hand, cupped hand in the middle, hard hand.
You just got to practice, and little by little you're gonna get it. Yeah, you can. I mean, you got kids, you got girls that play.
Right.
Like,
no, it's not for me. I'm a lawyer.
Yeah.
I like to watch. I want to watch and listen. That's my thing. Wow.
It's not that hard. I mean.
So do you tune yourself? You know, I mean, tune the congas yourself?
I do that too.
Really?
Yeah.
So how do you know, like, are they measured?
No, they're not measured. You just got to, like, I mean,
by
listen,
ear?
Yeah, listen to the sound. And you're going to get it little by little. Just like move them and tie them up and loosen up if you need them. And then the same thing with the other one. I mean, so then when you mix them, you see, they sound different. This one is lower, this one is higher.
Okay. Now, as a professional player, do you have preference in band, or you're just like, nope, just put something in front of me and I'm good?
No, I mean, I just play with whatever they give me. I mean, but if they ask me, you know, I just tell them to give me like LPs, you know, like
this one of the better brands?
Yeah, better brands. This one and the Pearl, yeah, LP and Pearl. That's what I, you know, if they got them, they can lend them to me, you know, whatever. So I'm good. If not, whatever they got, I just like.
He said, I'm a player, baby. I'm a percussionist. I'm a player. You put it in front of me, I'm a beat.
Do you ever
beat
have like a routine that you do, like with dancers and stuff, like, you know, with the Rocksteady crew, like when you play with them?
No, because every time that I play with them, I play, everything is like freestyle. I do like, I just play break beats.
And they go off.
Yeah. Wow. So, I mean, because, you know, it's going to be like, I mean, they're going to be b-boying. So I'm not going to have like a routine. I just got to go off so they can dance. So when they dance, that moves me.
Wow. Right.
So it's like a mix between
you're feeding off of each other,
so,
right?
So now, so